Good afternoon, esteemed members of the press, our beloved friends from the social media and from the press. Thank you so much for gracing our occasion, our launch for Kanser, the musical, 35 years. But of course, 35 years will not be around for Kanser if not for Gantimpala, who has survived the 38 years. No? Ang dami pong nangyari sa Gantimpala. At first, when we were starting, it was still called Espejo, I'm sure you know him very well. And at the prodding of Tony, with the help of Tita Pilipasila, a national artist at CCTN, Gantimpala started. And it was Tony who initiated the new trend in theater then, late 70s, when he introduced the new works of Filipino playwrights in Filipino. Hindi sila na main stage, they were not even produced, they were just written. These plays were the winners of the Gantimpala Playwriting Contest at CCP. And they were just stacked at the library of CCP. Tony Espejo was the one who initiated. He gave birth to a new beginning of theater. He was the one who said that we will stage this new place. It was a bold move. It was a very, very innovative move. And it was welcome. But of course, not without any struggles. Not without any disappointments. 38 years, we have moved on. After 10 years at Bulwagang Gantimpala, which is now the same, but today, it was the place where Tony staged the laboratory works of Gantimpala Playwriting Contest. 10 years we stayed at CCP and we gave birth to new plays, we gave the people productions that were memorable. And one of them was Kanser. After 10 years, we moved on to San Miguel Auditorium. But it was a short-lived one because the building of San Miguel was torn down to give way to a new building. And at San Miguel Auditorium, we would have along Ayala Avenue children or students lining up the length of Ayala. And people would we're just wondering what's going on. Why are these children lining up San Miguel? It's not for their beer. So it was because Kanser was being staged at the San Miguel Auditorium. There was an auditorium there. I mean, I don't know if you remember. Some of you haven't been born yet, I'm sure. Yes, Mateo. So, and then we moved on to the Metropolitan Theater and we stayed there for another 10 years until the net has to close down. And then that's when we moved from our house at San Antonio Village, which is an apartment, and we stayed there for another 5 or 6 years or so. And that's the time that we moved on to Concert at the Park. We have been like a wandering Jew. We don't have what we call a home, unfortunately, up to now. Up to now, we are at the AFP Theater, who graciously housed us as our part of their mga kasama sa teatro. That's why where we hold our productions for the past 15 years. No? So since AFP opened, we've been producing plays there. Our four classics, that is the Florante, or Smolly, or Kanser, Philly, and even Adar. But not to mention our other productions, we have also staged regional musicals for children. And as you can see, many of these are our stage also at the AFPTF. 38 years that Gantimpala has been in existence. In fact, it is one of the pioneers in theater, the contemporary theater that we have. We are the third. Number one is repertory, number two is Peta. Peta will be celebrating their 50th year. Within 2 years' time, we will be celebrating our 40th. So watch out! Watch out for our 40th year. Then, of course, we are very, very grateful with Kanser because it is our flagship production of Gantimpala. Kanser has been produced, I don't know how many, we lost count. But we claim that Kanser is the longest running production or contemporary play in the theater business. So ladies and gentlemen, I hope you enjoy this afternoon. May I introduce to you our artistic director, Mr. Joel Laman.
Tutok na sa Wazzup, Pilipinas. Ibutin ang mundo, kainin ang gusto. Alamin ng tamang daan kung paano ang umaseso. Kasama ang buong tropa ng Wazzup, Pilipinas. Aming ibibigay sa madla at ipapadanas. Ang saya ng Wazzup, Pilipinas. Tutok na sa Wazzup, Pilipinas. Ang saya dito sa Pilipinas. Ihahatid sa inyo ng Wazzup, Pilipinas.